Alright, my opponent kept 7. I am also going to keep. This hand is quite acceptable. Would not mind another land that comes into play untapped, just because as of now I'm playing turn 1 Mystic Monastery, and then turn 2 after the side between playing Flooded Strand, Soulfire Grandmaster, or playing Mystic Monastery, so I can play Hordling Outburst. So I'll see what I draw and see what my opponent does here. I've got 2 draw steps before I have to decide. And Opulent Palace. So it could be Sultai Control. I mean, that's the most likely scenario. I think I'm just going to run Soulfire Grandmaster here. And I'll get a Plains. Don't need tons of blue, and God's Willing makes me want slightly more white. CDC Whip is, of course, an option too, but again, I think it's much more likely that my opponent is playing Sultai Control here. Alright, I'll just play another Soulfire Grandmaster. And hopefully I don't get Bioblighted. Did not get Bioblighted. Very nice. Now I'm not going to play Hordling Outburst into Crux of Fate. Cure the Crashing Wave. So just drawing a card and playing an extra land. Alright, I suppose I'll take that. Let's just play Jeskai Ascendancy. And let's see, attack Kiora, attack my opponent here. Don't mind this position. I've got Jeskai Ascendancy out, and then I'm just going to start to burn through my cards pretty quickly. I mean, my opponent does get to play cards like Sultai Charm to kill Ascendancy. Looks like I'm getting Cruxed here. Crux of Fate, of course, blowing everything up. Yeah, let's go with the Hordling Outburst. Trigger Ascendancy. And right now, I was going to say more likely discard God's Willing, but here I think I can just discard Battlefield Forge because I can just play Mystic Monastery. I don't really... Though, maybe I should have discarded Mystic Monastery because of Bioblight. Yeah, I suppose that's a reasonable consideration. Let's take a look at my graveyard here. Not because the contents actually matter, just because I have 5 cards right now. Alright. I guess given that I have protection, alright, let's just go ahead and stoke my opponent. And this is one of the cool combos here, is I get to stoke triggering Ascendancy here. Let's use Jeskai Ascendancy's ability. Yeah, let's discard the temple. Nug my opponent, and I have 7 now, so now I can cast Treasure Cruise for the full amount. Did I delve them all? Oh, there we are. And at this point, I'm likely to discard Jeskai Ascendancy here. Yes, I want all the burn spells. Make my tokens into 3/3s, get to draw some cards. And do I want to play the land? Yeah, let's play the land. Because I think I want to keep up Lightning Strike as well. Let's stoke. And I'm aiming to hit my opponent for lots and lots of damage. I mean, this is now lethal, and I have a God's Willing to protect my tokens. Alright, well, that was pretty sick. I get to go off, draw lots of cards, kill my opponent's stuff, and then... It is kind of awkward siding in Counterspells and Outpost Siege, but I think both cards are just very good. And you've got a lot of cards that you don't really want, like Lightning Strikes don't really do a whole lot. Valorous Stances, not really great. Stoke is at least a lot of damage, same with Jeskai Charm. But, of all these, I think the last card I'm going to end up wanting to cut here is either a Soulfire Grandmaster or a Stoke the Flames. And I'm not 100% sure which one I want. I guess the Grandmaster is cheaper. I think I can cut the Stoke. I like God's Willing because it protects Monastery Mentor and Soulfire Grandmaster from things. It also stops Bioblade on your Hordling Outburst type effects. It's possible to cut Jeskai Ascendancy too, but... I'll start by cutting. Alright, what do we got? Oh, very capable hand. Because I've got turn 2 Raise the Alarm, turn 3 Jeskai Ascendancy with the Cruise and the Stoke and all that. I do need to draw some lands to make that happen, but I've got a good start here. Here we go. Mystic Monastery being a pretty nice little land for this deck, I'm not going to lie. And yeah, now I do want to curve out of Raise into Jeskai Ascendancy, so... Gonna play this. I'm not too worried about a counterspell. If my opponent is going to counter Raise the Alarm, I think I'd rather that happen than them countering Jeskai Ascendancy. And I did not get Bioblooded, so let's just attack. And then play Ascendancy off this island here. And if that gets countered or Sultai Charmed, again, so be it. Looks like my opponent is going to get to use their mana end of turn, which is unfortunate. But, yeah, natural, or Unravel the Aether. Huh. You know, that's actually kind of better to naturalize for my opponent, just because I don't get to enable Treasure Cruise. I do get to redraw the same Jeskai Ascendancy, but... Ooh, Crucible of the Spirit Dragon, nice. The Flavor Fail does not cast Ugin, the Spirit Dragon. Alright, so I'm not going to Stoke this turn. I think this turn I just attack for two, then play a Temple. I've got these Treasure Cruises that I guess I want to cast at some point, but I don't really need to go nuts doing that this instant. Like playing Stokes to enable that. Do I want the second Raise the Alarm? It's kind of awkward against Bioblade. I actually think I can do better. Let's see what my opponent's got here. I mean, at the very least, charging Crucible. But it could be like Sultai Charm, draw two, discard one. Which is a kind of aggressive use of Sultai Charm, given that it blows up Jeskai Ascendancy in my deck. But I guess my opponent feels confident that that's not happening anytime soon. Discarding Ugin, the Spirit Dragon. So I've got a Disdainful Stroke. I'm looking to counter... I mean, I guess I don't even care about Crux of Fate right now. I don't know, Silumgar is a card that seems likely to be in my opponent's deck, given Crucible of the Spirit Dragon. Draw Monastery Mentor. That's kind of nice. I might play Monastery Mentor because I can hit my opponent, and then if my opponent taps out to cast... Oh, Bioblade, that's fine. Yeah, now I'm definitely playing this. If my opponent does tap out to cast Crucible, or Crux of Fate, rather, I get to Disdainful Stroke it. Alright, charge our Crucible. And I'm getting close-ish to being able to cast Treasure Cruise. Like, if I put one more card in the graveyard and then draw a land, I can cast it. And hopefully my opponent didn't see anything like God's Willing. Not that I have one in hand right now, but they might run into a situation where they do not play around it. Would have been nice to have one of those Raise the Alarm tokens out so I could cast Stoke the Flames in response to something like Bioblight, but sadly I'm not there. Alright, draw. Alright. Now I'm definitely passing. I mean, I can't even cast Treasure Cruise anyway, but I wouldn't really want to tap out for Treasure Cruise here. My opponent's getting close to being able to play something good, like, I don't know, Big Garrick or something. Something that I'd want to Disdainful Stroke. And now I get to go end of turn, Raise the Alarm, and then probably Stoke the Flames just so I can cast a cheaper Treasure Cruise. Alright. Satyr Wayfinder, revealing Crux, Negate, Dig Through Time, and Land. Of course, the land going into my opponent's hand here. Alright, let's cast Raise the Alarm. And Stoke the Flames my opponent. Yeah, I got my opponent in a 10 with just a Raise the Alarm so far, and then now Stoke the Flames. Alright, let's attack, I guess. And do I want to cast Treasure Cruise here? Yeah, I don't really want to tap out again, but... So I'll just play Temple and pass. Well, I guess if my Temple could show me something. Do I want Flooded Strand? It is interesting. Flooded Strand does make... Yeah, you know, even though it makes Treasure Cruise cheaper, I don't really want to draw a Flooded Strand, so I think I'd rather just wait. The cool thing about this deck is that even if my opponent has something like Silumgar, if I can resolve a Jeskai Ascendancy, then it doesn't even matter that much, because at end of turn I can just make a bunch of tokens, or when my opponent attacks, feed the clan? Alright, I'm glad my opponent's siding in cards like that. It's not... When I do... Often when this deck does damage, it does lots of damage. Alright, Sheevan Reef. Let's play Treasure Cruise. And what I don't want to do, I think I actually am going to leave a card in my graveyard. I want to keep up Disdainful Stroke, but I want to be able to enable the next Treasure Cruise. I don't need to keep 3 mana up. Alright, Dissolve. Tis unfortunate. And here I don't really want to trade, just because I have cards like Jeskai Ascendancy in my deck and Stoke the Flames. Alright, opponent put a card on top, unfortunately. Well, my opponent's on 3 cards and I'm on 2 cards, so we're not that different in terms of what we have, the access, or what resources we have access to. So if I draw like a negate, huh? that feels pretty good. And so now I can just pass. It's not like a guarantee that my opponent can outcard me. I'm playing 4 Treasure Cruise. Yeah, you can Sultai Charm. And my opponent's playing some amount of digs and cruises as well, but Sultai Charming and discarding one, I mean, I don't know, your card neutral there. Alright, this I'm probably gonna counter. I'll Disdainful Stroke that. I'm actually, the reason I'm Disdainful Stroking instead of negating there is that I would like to fight over Treasure Cruise with negate, and my negate can counter my opponent's negate or dissolve. Even though this does leave me vulnerable to exactly something like Silumgar or an expensive creature, because negate still counters a planeswalker. Like, maybe this? Yep, alright. Who's the control deck now? Stateful Stroke, negate, untap Treasure Cruise into more action. That's the plan, at least. I want to get to the point where I'm buying back Treasure Cruises with Soulfire Grandmaster. I'm not there yet, though. Alright. Cruise into a Disdainful Stroke. So we're going to play Soulfire Grandmaster and leave up Disdainful Stroke. Might get to a point where I can lock my opponent with Soulfire Grandmaster Disdainful Stroke. Because that is also pretty sweet. Drown in Sorrow. That I cannot counter. And I'm going to put a card on the bottom. Still feeling pretty good about this. I'm going to keep this land in hand now. Because Jeskai Ascendancy makes me want to discard. Alright, Dissolve. Alright, so I have a card ahead of my opponent, but my opponent put a card on top, so this is a pretty close game. I've already used 2 of my 4 Treasure Cruises, but I still have 2 Outpost Siege and 2 Treasure Cruise left in my deck as good draws here. Jeskai Ascendancy, also pretty strong draw, because I can just play it, and then if I have to cast Disdainful Stroke, I end up drawing extra cards off it. Let's play Flooded Strand before I draw all my Flooded Strandable lands here. Crucible Spirit Dragon is going off. Opponent can cast a 1 mana Silumgar. Is this another Sultai Charm? No, this looks like a Dig Through Time or Ingenuity, which I'm definitely countering. Just Disdainful Stroke that. If I get negated here, then I'm in trouble. Yeah, that is accurate. Yeah. We went from me having a stroke and my opponent having no cards, my opponent having dig and negate, and me still having just the stroke. Though, that was 2 scries later, so. Now I assume that I'm going to lose this game. Given that my opponent has not very many cards left in their deck. Yeah, and I'm out of counters, so. Opponent's got 4 cards in hand. I would assume at least 2 of which are good spells. And maybe it's just 1, maybe my opponent dug into Jace Ingenuity plus another spell, and then Ingenuity into 3 land, but seems unlikely. Alright, here's the dragon. I imagine a 3-7 hexproof is coming. Yeah. And I'm going to sack Flooded Strand, I guess. Draw for the turn. Alright, well, Jeskai Ascendancy is a card. I'm not just dead yet. I don't think I'm in good shape by any stretch, but at least with a Jeskai Ascendancy out, I have options. Kiora. Yeah. So my best draw here. Well, opponent's only got 2 cards now. Silumgar is a slow clock, and now with Jeskai Ascendancy out, every spell I draw gives me a loot here. Alright, so now we're talking. I don't think this is going to resolve, but if it does, then maybe I'm just back in the game. Yeah, it didn't resolve, but I still get to loot here. And I'm going to get to play an outpost siege and loot again. And I'm at 16 still. Alright, discarding land clearly. And outpost siege, choosing cons. And pass the turn. Alright. And we're definitely in it now. If my opponent doesn't have another dig through time, which they probably do, then I get to essentially see three or four cards next turn. And like I get to see one from my draw step, one off outpost siege, and then an extra one off triggering Jeskai Ascendancy. And every other non-creature lets me see more cards. Alright, Exiled Negate. Well, that is part of the awkwardness. I would have much rather drawn Negate than than revealed it, but I still think having these cards is fine though. Alright. Now I just need to draw like a Raise the Alarm and end of turn Raise the Alarm, and then I have a pretty good shot at just killing my opponent on my turn. I wonder who has more of an advantage, my opponent with Kiora and Silumgar, or me with Outpost Siege and double Jeskai Ascendancy. Alright, see, now I get to play Monastery Mentor with double protection up, which I think is very good for me. And I think I start with God's Willing. Yeah. Let's put my triggers on the stack, I guess. Do I want to just mill? I guess I'm probably casting Negate here. So at this point, I don't see, because I have enough cards to enable my last treasure cruise, I don't think it's good for me to mill. Is it? Yeah, actually I'm going to. Alright, good call. I guess I might as well mill up to 7 here. Of course, my opponent could have Crux of Fate here, which would be annoying, but even if my opponent doesn't have actual Crux of Fate, alright, now I don't need to do any more. Silumgar is going to wipe out the monks here, but I'm going to have Monastery Mentor in play still. Yeah, I'll put this on top. With this much mana, I think Soulfire Grandmaster is good. And there's a decent chance I do lose the Mentor this turn. Losing the monks, but Mentor itself could be a pretty big game. Alright, looks like my Mentor is getting plused on Kiora, so it's not dying. So now I reveal Soulfire Grandmaster and draw another Jeskai Ascendancy. So I guess I play Jeskai Ascendancy. Yeah, the monks are still gonna die. I need to at some point find an instant here, but then play Soulfire Grandmaster and pass the turn. So we're in the same spot as last time, except I'm going to keep a Soulfire Grandmaster and a Monastery Mentor out. My opponent could use Kiora to draw a card, but then I'd have two threats. I also only get to take one more hit after this off Silumgar before I'm dying. Yeah, Drowning Sorrow is going to be tough. Okay. And draw a card. Uh-oh, what is this? Another dig through time? Yeah, I suspect things are not going well for me now. I mean, they already kind of weren't, but I thought I was coming back a little bit. But dig through time is going to make that much more difficult. Alright, let's reveal with Outpost Siege some action. Monastery Mentor with Stoke the Flames. Alright. Play Monastery Mentor. I could Stoke the Flames, Kiora. I'm getting dissolved. Okay, I guess that's fine. At this point, I'm just looking to Stoke the Flames of my opponent and then untap and reveal burn spells off Outpost Siege. How many Stokes do I have left? Actually, I don't even know if I have enough left to kill my opponent here. Yeah, we'll find out. I go to one. My opponent might just minus Q. No, they're plusing. Alright. I think because of mana considerations, I should just do this now and then not Jeskai Ascendancy here. Put these triggers all in the stack and say no for all of them. No, 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 and also no on Kiora. Oh, I'm getting countered anyway. Wait, what's happening here? Oh, my opponent cast Feed the Clan. Alright. Soulfire Grandmaster in land. Actually, Soulfire Grandmaster is maybe a reason to wait, because I could have gained life off Stoke. Huh, that's interesting. Alright, do you want to change anything? I mean, there wasn't anything I didn't know about. Like, Silumgar's annoying, but it's not the end of the world. I still have enough instants, I think, to play fine here. Yeah, I think I'm good. Well, I would, in fact, like to play first. Oh yeah, I'm keeping this hand. This hand is great. Lead with Mystic Monastery here. It's always interesting whether you lead with Temple or Monastery on turn one. I usually like having a little more info before playing my tempo, or Temple. Don't think I need that. Because I drew the land, for example, and now I can bin a land. If I played Temple turn one and saw a mountain, I might keep it, and I don't think I like that quite as much. Alright, Seder Wayfinder off Yavimaya Coast Island, indicating my opponent does not have more lands in hand. But now hit Temple of Mystery and or Land Wastes, so. But you would definitely play a tap land turn one. And unless my opponent, I guess, could have only blue or black tap lands, but I don't even know if that deck plays. Like, it has Opulent Palace and Temple of Malady and whatnot. Actually, let's just play Monastery Mentor here. And then I can play Outpost Siege next turn. Mentor actually pressuring my opponent. Ooh, play another Seder Wayfinder. I like the sound of that. And what did my opponent reveal? More temples, Pluto Delta. Alright. So I assume playing a temple this turn. Passing, then I get to go Outpost Siege, which lets my mentor attack, and it also puts two threats on the board, so my opponent can't likely kill both in the same turn. I guess Bioblight plus Naturalize or Unravel the Aether, but then you also have, I still have a monk in play. We're in chump block mode already, which makes sense if you've got, like, especially if you have, I guess Dig already had six, but if you're planning on casting Drown in Sorrow this turn, for example. Alright. So sadly, my Outpost Siege is getting unraveled. Alright, let's attack. Let's attack with Monastery Mentor. Do we want to trade a monk for a Seder Wayfinder? Alright. Let's play. Oop, get some combat damage step somehow. Alright, let's play Soulfire Grandmaster here. I want to keep Disdainful Stroke up. I think if my opponent had Drown in Sorrow, they would have played it. Obviously, I could be making a huge error here. I'm more worried about Crux of Fate than I am Drown in Sorrow. Though I probably shouldn't have played the Soulfire Grandmaster, just waited a turn. Is my guess. Yeah. Obviously, if one of these was a negate, that would be completely different, but I think this was just overextending for no reason. Well, here we go. Played now Jeskai Ascendancy before attacking, clearly. In order to get my prowess going. I think my opponent's going to play Jace's Ingenuity here. Yeah, drawing the second Grandmaster makes me not too unhappy that I played the first one, but I do kind of wish I hadn't played the first one now. Like, my opponent's got to have a play end of turn. I do think I want to play Jeskai Ascendancy, though. I think if it's a Jace's Ingenuity or a Dig Through Time, I think I do want to counter it. And it seems more likely it's a Jace's Ingenuity if you fetched your fifth land. I know, it looks like a dig, but you can't leave... You can only leave Negate up. Yeah, I still think I'm going to Disdainful Stroke here. Yeah, let's put some tokens on this, or triggers on the stack. Yeah, let's draw a card and discard a card. Alright. And if my opponent then kills all my things, cast Feed the Clan? Took a damage to cast Feed the Clan? What's going on here? Well, yeah, I'm going to lose all my creatures now, probably, but I'm going to have Jeskai Ascendancy out and play a Soulfire Grandmaster. I wish my Outpost Siege hadn't been killed. I wouldn't. I'm glad I countered the dig, though, because I couldn't counter Drowning Sorrow, so... Alright, let's play Soulfire Grandmaster. And I need to find a Treasure Cruise or another Outpost Siege. Or just hit some spells to trigger Ascendancy. Obviously, I'm not playing Mystic Monastery because I want to loot with Ascendancy here. And take my turn. Alright, there's a Treasure Cruise. Though I think I just wait on that. Given that I can't protect it. I mean, I'd like to draw like a negate, and also I'd have to tap out for it. Whereas, yeah, this would then resolve. If I had an untapped land, it'd be cool to be able to buy it back with Soulfire Grandmaster, but I don't. I should discard Monastery here, even though I only have one white source. Alright, so now I can next turn cast Treasure Cruise for the cheapest amount. Possible my opponent doesn't have much in the way of counterspells here. Silgar. Alright, well, at least that means my Treasure Cruise is going to resolve. Stoke the Flames is not bad either. Alright, let's cast Treasure Cruise for 2 mana. Actually, you know? Yeah, I think this is where we're at. Activate Soulfire Grandmaster, cast Treasure Cruise. And I am definitely looting here. this is actually kind of interesting. Do I want all these Treasure Cruises now? I think I actually have to discard Treasure Cruise here because I'm getting this Treasure Cruise back. Alright. Alright, well, I got to buy back a Treasure Cruise, so mission successful. My opponent can't really attack me. Let's play Outpost Siege with counter magic up. Don't care too much if this Outpost Siege resolves, though. Alright, discarding on Plains, because Floodestrand's much better here. No Outpost Siege. Alright. And play a land and pass the turn. I'm playing a land here because it's a fetch land and I've got Treasure Cruise. My plan is to end of turn cast, raise the alarm, you know, use Ascendancy to mill myself for one. I guess I should sack Flooded Strand. Oh, I see. Sylvengar's getting in there. Aggressive. Okay. What's coming down? Is that like a Kiora or something? An Ugin? Crux of Fate? Destroy all non-dragon creatures. I could let this happen, or I could Disdainful Stroke. Actually, I think this is okay. As good of service as Soulfire Grandmaster provided, I think I'm okay letting it die and then casting Raise the Alarm. So I'm just going to be able to do so much next turn. Uh, I guess I'll discard God's Willing. Since my opponent doesn't have Bioblight mana up anyway. Oh, it's getting countered. Alright, well, I feel like I'm heavily advantaged here given that I have Treasure Cruise in hand. Blue. 7. Ascendancy. Yeah, discard Temple. Ooh, this is one of the outposts he just got shuffled back in. Outpost Siege. Again, draw. And yeah, we're just going off. Let's discard Flooded Strand here, because I'm just going to leave Disdainful Stroke up and play Temple so I know what I'm removing with Outpost Siege. Yeah, put that on the bottom. Even if I miss next turn, I don't really want to hit Battlefield Forge, so I'll pass. Outcarding my opponent significantly here. Draw, Outpost Siege goes off. It's Flooded Strand. Play Flooded Strand. Sack Flooded Strand. I guess I just have the two targets left. Play Monastery Mentor. I think play Treasure Cruise? Yeah. And leaving up Disdainful Stroke. And not fighting over any of this, I don't think. My opponent is tapping blue-blue. Which I imagine you'd want to do, before Jeskai trigger resolves. Actually, I think I'd discard Monastery Mentor here. I'm going to lose the monk token, but that's okay. But I've got Disdainful Stroke again to stop, Dig Through Time or Ingenuity or Ugin or anything super threatening. And Jeskai Charm just does so much damage when you have Jeskai Ascendancy in play. That I feel like I'm in pretty good shape here. I have Stoke also. Hordling Outburst. Yeah, okay. I should just be able to win this turn. Barring something very strange. Because now I get to just go off with multiple Stokes too. The Mentor itself is just going to deal millions of damage. Yeah, this deck's sweet when it goes off. I guess I discard. No, my opponent has one card. Yeah, I discard Disdainful Stroke because Negate can handle the last thing. And yeah, might as well just go for the Gusto here. Even though I could also just Jeskai Charm my opponent to death here. There's just so many ways I can finish this game. And I have enough burn just to burn my opponent without attacking, but I still am going to have a 8-8 Monastery Mentor attacking my opponent here. With Negate up. And I had Disdainful Stroke up basically this entire game, so I was never too much in danger of having my opponent do much, so. Opponent's saying good game, so I will accept. And that'll do it. Yeah. Still think they probably didn't want to bring in Feed the Clan. Look at these games are not really about life totals. They're about who can draw more cards. But it's kind of cool that this deck can actually fight that battle. So we'll see if it happens next round as well.